any flaws really with Gennady Golovkin. This is such a mammoth task for Kell Brook.
He is 4 years younger, but there's not a lot else going in his favour. The reach advantage, the natural middleweight size, obviously, of Golovkin. Nothing much in fights professionally. They're both undefeated, 91% KO. Massive for Golovkin. How will Kell Brook deal with the inevitable power whenever it comes?
Well, that's the biggest question, the biggest concern, and it should be the biggest worry for Kell Brook's team, how he responds when he is hit to the body and especially the head.
Yeah, I think before the bell rings, you don't even think about that if you're Kell Brook. You put that in the last thing in your mind. You think of the game plan you're going to execute, being first and being sharp so that you cannot be countered off of that sharpness.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we will honor challenger and champion with their respective national anthems. First, for the challenger, God Save the Queen. Defending world champion, the national anthem of Kazakhstan. Ladies and gentlemen, from the legendary O2 Arena, London, England, Eddie Hearn from Matchroom Boxing and K2 Promotions Managing Director Tom Loeffler, along with Triple G Promotions, are proud to present the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the middleweight championship of the world. Sponsored by Tesla Bond. Expo 2017, Capital Holding, StubHub, JD Sports, WeBuyAnything.com, and Daffabet. Broadcast by Sky Sports Pay-Per-View and HBO. Sanctioned by the British Boxing Board of Control, President and Steward in Charge tonight, Charles Giles. The World Boxing Council, President Mauricio Suleiman, Supervisor Alberto Leon. The International Boxing Federation President and Supervisor tonight, Darrell F. Peoples. The International Boxing Organization President and Supervisor tonight, Ed Levine. The three judges scoring, from Italy, Guido Cavalieri. From Canada, Craig Metcalf. From Canada, Benoit Rousseau. And in charge of the action at the bell, World Championship veteran referee, Marlon Wright from Canada. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the officials are in place and they are ready. The fighters are in the ring and they are ready. Boxing fans, are you ready? The thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world. From the O2 Arena, London, England, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner with his trainer, Dominic Engel, wearing red with gold trim. Official weight, 11 stone, 5 pounds, 1/2 ounce, or 159.4 pounds. His professional record, a perfect one, consisting of 36 fights, 36 victories, including 25 wins by knockout, with 16 stoppages inside the distance in his last 20 contests. Tonight, he is the challenger. He's the fighting pride of Sheffield, Yorkshire, England. The undefeated welterweight champion of the world, the special one, Hell, Special K. And across the ring, his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, with his trainer, Abel Sanchez, officially weighing in at 11 stone, 5 pounds, or 158.9 pounds. As a professional, also a perfect record. 35 fights, 35 victories, including 32 wins by knockout, including 22 consecutive KOs, and he has KO'd every opponent he's faced over the last 8 years. This Olympic medalist from Karaganda, Kazakhstan, is the reigning, defending, undefeated, universally recognized, true middleweight champion of the world, Gennadyevich Golovkin, a.k.a.
A monumental gamble, high stakes, remarkable risk for huge reward or ring failure on the starriest of stages. It's been hard to find anyone outside Kell Brook's inner circle who genuinely believes he can cause the sort of seismic shot that Sugar Ray Leonard did almost 30 years ago in Vegas against Marvin Hagler, or become a reigning world welterweight champion, to dethrone a reigning world middleweight champion like Emil Griffith did back in 1966. But you never know in boxing. So many questions. Can he take Golovkin's power? Will he have the extra speed? Early thoughts.
Well, nice left hook by Brook there, Carl.
Yes, nice left hook by Brook. If he can use his jab and his speed, as you say, the welterweight speed, and handle the power of Golovkin, then he's in with potentially a chance with this. I'm on the edge of my seat straight away because Golovkin marches forward and lets them thunderous punches go, and you just don't know how Brook's going to respond when he gets tagged with them shots. He needs to jab and move, he needs to be elusive. Great jab there by Brook. Golovkin doing what he does, backing his opponent up straight away with no concern, really.
He's stalking, he's powerful. He judges distance so well, Golovkin.
Golovkin pressures, but he doesn't move his head. I've been saying it all week, it's the one flaw I see, and Kell is taking advantage with a sharp counter right hand before. Nice jabs, counter jabs. This is how you domesticate a pressure guy, but you've got to watch the big powers. Kell just got touched there.
Yep, Golovkin backing Brook up into his own corner. There's the body shot, he's hurt early on in the first round. That's the first signs.
You got to hold when you're hurt, he's being smart.
This guy, Golovkin, has been knocking down light heavyweights and cruiserweights in sparring, and Kell Brook has never faced a middleweight in a ring like this. There's the uppercut. He comes back. What about these tactics as he tries to hurt Golovkin?
Golovkin's hittable, guys. Everybody makes like Golovkin gets hit on purpose. I don't believe it. He never moves his head. Brook, he will give Brook chances to land that speed.
I think we've had a question answered there straight away, and it's worrying signs. Kell Brook got tackled with a left hook early on there. Then his legs seem to, you know, go from under it. He looks like he's recovered, and he's responding back. But getting at Golovkin, he isn't doing much now, he's just having a look. But Brook there looked hurt, and it's worrying signs very early, straight away in round one here, and this massive task that he's got in front of him.
Brook staying calm through the pressure. This is what he's got to do. The guys tend to panic at this point right here when Golovkin traps them. Brook stays calm and he counters well.
But he's not moving. He's not using his feet.
But that's the thing. You don't want to go into flight. You just want to take little steps here and there. And I believe Kell's got the right game plan here. You plant when Golovkin doesn't come forward, so you can do this.
Oh, big uppercut from Brook and a right hand.
Great shots from Brook. They landed. I'm not sure how Golovkin responded to that, but it looked awful.
I'll tell you what. When was the last time Golovkin was backed up? And if Brook can do that, even momentarily, the confidence will just be running through his veins.
I like how Brook is not in flight. He's just taking little steps. He's planting and shooting and making the shots count.
You're right. He's not running.
The problem is he got rocked. So do you give him the... Was it? I mean, it was a big round aside, but he got hit with that big shot that rocked him. So you could give Golovkin the round.
Worrying round for Brook early on, but he responded very well.
These are his best shots. And you are...
Here's a shot that some shots on the ropes. Golovkin landed a good body shot, and that was that set up the head shot, which actually hurt Kell. Kell took it well, all things considered. That was a lethal shot, and Kell came back with some beautiful combinations.
Like I say, got hit with that left hook and he looked stunned momentarily. It looked like his legs went from under him a little bit, but he recovered well. And he landed some hurtful look. He's got a left hook there on Golovkin's chin.
Fighting fire with fire early. We
and
thought that might be.
He's got more skills. Here's the thing. That's what I've been saying. The athleticism of Kell. He's got more skills. Just this guy has a killer punch. Kell's able to step back with half steps and counters. He boxed well aside from getting hurt, but getting hurt may lose you the round.
Gennady Golovkin. 5 first round knockout wins in his career, 7 inside 2, 6 more in the third round. The monstrous puncher from Kazakhstan defending his world middleweight crown.
You see even the simple things Kell does. You see that counter jab. It just makes Golovkin stop in his tracks. It's not a power shot, but it'll make Golovkin stop in his tracks.
Both have got excellent jabs. But Brook says he feels comfortable at ease now at this weight. He hasn't dragged himself down. It's been a very positive start, Carl.
It has, yeah. I've just got up close when Golovkin's in front of Brook. The one thing here is Golovkin's able to push Brook back and sort of manhandle him and be in control up close. And as the fight wears on, if he does wear on, great response by Brook. There's landing some creative, clean shots here.
The creative Kell Brook offense, different angles, punches, uppercuts, punches around the side, straight shots.
Well, we've got to remember that Golovkin's never really been in with anybody as skillful and as talented naturally as Kell Brook. So he's in new territory here, Golovkin.
Through his professional career, is Kell Brook the most talented opponent? Everybody.
It's the total package that makes Kell Brook the most talented athlete.
But everybody was writing him off. You couldn't find one person, Paulie, in the media, full stop, who was backing Kell in this fight.
What's worrying for me, though, you're right there, Adam, no one's really backing him. What's worrying for me here, though, is Golovkin still able to mark for. Walked into a counter there. Counter from Brook.
But you see him clump
Killers. Really well, Brook is here. I'm just worried he's on his back foot. And Golovkin's almost able to do pretty much what he usually does, which is get momentum with his heavy hands moving forward. Brook's not running.
Yeah, exactly. He's just stepping back.
Trying to make his power tell early as well, Cal Brook, but Golovkin has centre ring. There's the right hand he's trying. He is marked up around the face. Never been really badly hurt. Certainly never been down, amateur or pro, Gennady Golovkin. What an uppercut from Cal Brook! A beautiful shot in the second round. Oh, a lovely right hand! And Golovkin is beckoning him in and says, come on then, let's go to war.
Amazing by Cal Brook. I'm amazed. He's standing right in the middle and tagging him.
Cal Brook here having unbelievable success. The uppercut, the right hook, the dead right hand.
Blood from the nose of Golovkin. We know he now respects Brook's power, certainly the angles and the speed. How's he going to react, Golovkin?
Well, the left hook from Golovkin looking a little bit cumbersome, a little bit slow. Too early to say, but he's not firing as sharp as he usually is. Brook boxing, superb moving. Great round from Brook. Great round.
I tell you what, this is one of the most incredible atmospheres I remember through 25 years of covering boxing at Sky. That night when Ricky Hatton beat Kostas Yu stands out, when Naz went to the Garden to fight Kevin Kelly. Your fight, obviously, with George Groves, but there's something here in the air. Is the unthinkable possible?
Well, it's that air of invincibility that Triple G brings to the ring. And now Brook is sort of throwing the script out of the window. I know it's only round two that's just a good, and it's early stages yet of the fight, but he's having some great success. I'm very impressed and shocked, if I'm honest, with what's happening.
Adam, you know what I'm even more impressed with? It's Kel's ability to control the pace. He's able to take his little walks. Look at how excited he got for his little guy.
Nassim Hammond,
he's a kid.
Called me this morning, we were on the phone for an hour. He said, believe, I've known this guy all my life. He's an animal, he's got something special inside him. He's not just got the skills, but he's going to stand there and beat Golovkin up.
And that's come from Nassim Hammond, who knows him very well. He's obviously going to be biased, but he sees him in the gym, he knows him inside out. And Kel is doing well. Just out of balance there, Kel's put most to the floor, just a balanced thing.
Look at Golovkin's face, though. He's getting frustrated. This is what I've never seen from Golovkin, who I was always curious about.
Really frustrated. No rushing at Golovkin. We don't see this. You're right, Paulie. Maybe he's rattled. Cal Brook needs to be careful now. Get a tight guard and close that gap. Don't be on the end of them shots.
Closing down the distance, Golovkin. Stalking. Ripping home shots. Trying to really back up Brook in the way he knows how. Those middle rounds where all the stoppages come. 3, 4, 5, 6 body shots. How's Cal Brook going to take the shots to the torso, to the solar plexus? That's where Matthew Macklin struggled. He's complaining about an eye here, Cal.
Look at his corner there, distressing signs. You don't like to see that. He's blinking. He's worried about something. He needs to just get on with it.
Speed, though. Creative punch selection and speed.
For anyone that thought he would go swiftly around the ring using mobility and adaptability, he's turned it into a mini hack that hurts this.
He took a great right hand there from Golovkin from Cal Brook, and he just brushed it off. He looked okay with that power. And this is what I wanted to see, how he responded to the power. And I'm very happy with the way he took that shot and responded. Just got to say, early doors, but Golovkin looks rattled, he looks upset. He's firing, he's moving forward. And he's letting these shots go, but he's looking marked around the face, bruised and swollen.
Yeah, but he's a thin card. Kel cannot take shots like that from this big puncher consistently.
That's right, Paulie. Can't be taking big shots from Golovkin. I'm getting excited from what I'm seeing, but it's looking dangerous. But Brook responding well.
Nice combinations back from Brook and the uppercut. That's the one they want to see.
He's got to go to the body. He's not gone to the body yet. I want to see a body shot from Cal Brook. He's a great body puncher.
But this is what Cal Brook brings to the ring, these variety of punches, his skill, his natural ability. Golovkin is not enjoying this.
Golovkin nods, and there's blood from the nose of Cal Brook. It's such a valiant, brave, attacking start. Can he keep this going, or will Golovkin find a way to subdue the storm and break him up?
Just worried about that weight of that natural weight advantage from Golovkin, and he feels that natural
weight for Golovkin.
But Brooke is marking up badly as well.
Swelling by Brooks, right eye.
Golovkin was a man on a mission when the round started. He came out with that extra pressure to make a statement to Brooke this round.
Back comes Brooke. It's sensational sizzling action here at the O2 as they go toe-to-toe. What a fight!
Unbelievable stuff. Getting the Golovkin there, hitting after the bell, which is signs of frustration. I can't really split them in that round. It's not what I expected. Fantastic from Kell Brook. I'm just worried that that weight from Golovkin, that natural size of weight and strength, will start to tell as this fight weighs on. Dominic Kingwell there, so furious in the corner, furious with the success of trying to get inside Kell Brook's head and trying to probably keep him believing.
Now, last round, Golovkin came out flying. How do you start this next round if you're Brooke? Do you expect that same rush from Golovkin, or do you rush him and play the mind game back to him?
With the early success from Kell Brook, is he in danger of becoming too macho here, Paulie, as Golovkin comes back at him there?
There's a fine line with the macho stuff, because I think Brooke, after that round where Golovkin tried to boss it, Brooke may need to come out trying to boss this round. But honestly, it's a personal decision here. I don't know.
That eye is badly marked up for Kell Brook. I'll tell you what, it's been pulsating here.
You know, we're talking about how is the weight going to affect Kell as the bigger man is attacking, but Golovkin's wasted a lot of energy, and he himself is taking some shots.
Now he goes to the body. That's what you wanted to see from Brook. But if Golovkin matches fire with fire to the body, that could unhinge Brook.
That's the thing, Adam. Golovkin's gone to the body already. Kell's taking it well. Obviously, you never want to take too many body shots, but I'd like to see Kell touch him up a little bit to the body, because he's getting Golovkin's hands up with all the landed head shots. The body will be open.
Brooke landed some great combinations, body to head, but he's on his back foot. He's taking shots in the counter, and he's marked up like I've never seen him before. That right high of Kell Brook, looking like he wants to close, which is bad signs. If that does close, he'll be in trouble. And his back's against his ropes. Great
hand from Brook. Again, the nod from Golovkin, but it just bounces off his chin.
Yeah, but they're scoring blows, Adam. They're scoring blows. There's a round-winning shot.
This can't go the distance, Paulie, surely.
I don't know. I mean, the way it is, I don't know if Kell Brook's orbit bone is broken. I had that injury with Miguel Cotto. His eye is swelling rapidly.
It's a shootout, but there's some clever, classy work going in.
He's still staying so calm, just making Golovkin miss by ever so little. It takes a calmness to you. It takes a real skill to do that, especially when you know the guy punches as hard as Golovkin.
Fantastic talent, Kell Brook, and he's showing that in this fight here. He's just keeping out of range. He's staying calm under pressure. Yes, he's getting hit, but he's not getting hit with punches he doesn't see coming.
And he's still thinking. He's still, despite the rest, he's still thinking. His shots are still creative. Yeah, he's moving a little more than he was a couple of rounds ago, but he's still got his eyes wide open, seeing the shots, trying to turn Golovkin.
I just want to see Brook put some combination together when he's against them ropes. Golovkin marches forward. You need that uppercut, right hand, left hook, 3-4 punches, just to keep Golovkin at bay and give him something to think about. Don't back up and sit there and soak these shots up, because it's going to have a detrimental effect.
Trying to get the jab going, Golovkin doesn't look perturbed, even though he hasn't found his normal rhythm or range. Congratulate Brook for that. Whatever happens now, it's been a monumental effort as he smiles, Kell Brook.
Is that jab? He's got to keep using it. There it is, because Golovkin does not move his head.
But when Daniel Gill hit him, he knocked Gill out.
Of course. Well, that's why you got to move your head after you land. Golovkin's got a great chin. We know that already. It's a matter of landing the shots to score and maybe slowing him down ever so little so you can get some breathing room during the round.
Tries the uppercut again, partially blocked from Golovkin. This is a man, Kell Brook, that's only had the likes of Kevin Bisier, Jojo Dow, Frankie Gavin to deal with at welterweight. Now he's in with this guy, Golovkin, the man, the fearsome reputation. And how is he handling himself?
Let me tell you, if Kell Brook was a middleweight, I would not be worried at all. The only reason I'm worried about Brook at the minute is because of this weight issue. I know they're both weighing in the middleweight, but he's not a middleweight, Kell Brook. This is phenomenal from Brook. I'm so impressed, and Golovkin doesn't look like he's enjoying himself. But I go back again. He's now on his front foot, and he's backing Brook up.
Guys, I don't know, maybe I'm being biased, but
Do you know what? We couldn't wait for this first bell to go. The anticipation. Who could have thought we'd have four rounds like that? Extraordinary.
And Brook came back after a very tough third round, and he could have won that fourth round. I mean, he boxed well, landed a nice check hook there as he, on the way out, on the, as we saw in that replay just now. Smart decision-making, even under duress. There's a sharp shooting right hand there. You know, he could have won the fourth round after a very difficult third round, and that shows mental fortitude.
Dominic Ingle working on the eyes. John Ingle's around as well. They've been with Kell pretty much the whole way since he was 9 years old and walked into that Winkabank gym. Alexa Harold Bomber Graham, Johnny Nelson, Prince Nassim Hammond, Ryan Rhodes, the conveyor belt of talent. And when their backs are to the wall, this is where the Winkabank fighters deliver. But Gennady Golovkin still marches on. As if, okay, you're giving me your best, now it's my turn. Backing Brook up, and those left hooks are worrying.
But Brook, Brook is riding with some of them, Adam. He's not taking them fully cleanly. Not that you want to see this.
Can he keep his shoulders on his back foot? You're right, he's riding the shots, but he's under relentless pressure.
But let's see if Brook can punch himself out now. I want to see now if Kell answers back here.
Yeah, macho there from Kell Brook, showing, look, I'm not hurt, is that all you've got? But these punches are hurting. Let me tell you, I can feel them sat here at ringside. And Brook does not want to be at the end of these punches in punching range here with Golovkin. He needs to start letting combination shots go, and he's not happy with his right eye.
I'm telling you guys, his orbit bone might be broke. The socket, the eye socket might be broke. I know that injury. It's a weird feeling.
Still catches Golovkin.
He's got the skill out of him. He's naturally, you know, he's got this talent, he's got this ability. And Golovkin's not been in front of anybody that can land this array of shots. Golovkin's not enjoying getting hit with these shots, but I don't think they're having a bad enough effect on him.
He finds a way, though, Gennady Golovkin. Like he did against Gregor Proxer, against Curtis Stevens. So many have tried and failed. Our own great Matthew Macklin. But Brooks already lasted into the fifth round. But the ears are getting heavy now. The artillery, Brooks seeks back.
The towel's come out from Dominic Ingle.
The towel's there from Dominic Ingle. And Gennady Golovkin is going to retain his world middleweight title. The towel has come in. The referee didn't see it.
You did not see that towel.
And it is all over. Gennady Golovkin just proved too much, too strong, too naturally big. Not great for Brook, just too big.
That's the fun.
And that's the key.
That was the key. That was the entire key. This is a monster puncher at middleweight.
You know what, at the end there, Paulie, he was under pressure, he was taking shots, left up, right up, uppercuts, double jab right hands, and you can see Brook was not going to quit. Dominic Ingle there, very compassionate there for his man.
Credit.
I like to see that, it's a great stoppage. The referee was not going to stop it.
A big credit to Dominic Ingle, man. He knows Kell since he's young. He knows what he can and can't take. He actually let him take some of the punishment because he knew his guy could come back, and Kell came back wonderfully in some moments in that fight. But he knew when it was time, and he knew when his guy had nothing left to give back.
There was just signs, wasn't there, in the last 3-4 minutes that the pressure and the natural advantage that Golovkin was always going to have as the rounds tick by just paid off. But Brook, what an effort. What an effort.
Unbelievable effort. I've never seen anything like it in recent years in modern-day boxing. To come up from welterweight to face somebody like Triple G, but he showed me there, he showed me vulnerabilities of Triple G. He got hit with a lot of shots. He didn't look like he was enjoying himself. And as far as I'm concerned, the only reason Gennady Golovkin came through there in the end was that size and natural weight advantage.
Yeah, you know, Kell might have broke the orbit bone. Again, I'm not a doctor. I'm just guessing here. He might have broke the orbit bone with that first left hook that hit him, that hurt him in the first round.
But still, Gennady Golovkin reigns unbeaten in 36, the 33rd knockout. Even when there were signs, he discovers something inside himself as he drills forward, unloading the punches, powerful head and body.
And look at the balance. Look at how he's able to follow through with other shots forcefully, because Golovkin does not get too excited when his offense is working for him. Look at how he's constantly maintaining balance, kept Brook under duress, and forced the stoppage. He's a straight right hand. But where is he? He's right in front of Brook again. Brook cannot find the escape. And look at the follow-up combinations. And eventually the towel came in right here, right about here. I don't know what Marlon B. Wright was looking at. I mean, That towel was out for about 20 seconds.
And Dominic Ingle reading it, like you guys, sensing enough is enough.
Yes, he was leaving Brook in there for long enough to see if he had any answers and to see if there was any response, and also giving him a chance to see if Gennady Golovkin could be hurt by Brook, which I don't think he really could. He was stunned early on in the fight, but that natural weight and size as the fight pressed on became really evident there. And great stoppage by Dominic Ingle. Really glad he did what he did.
What a stunning fight while it lasted. Congratulations, Gennady Golovkin, still the world middleweight king. But Kell Brook, you made your name tonight even more than ever before.
Even on the world stage, I think people will know and credit Kell Brook more for this fight than they will for all his wins. And that's really a shame, because Kell Brook was always a terrific fighter, even before tonight. I've been singing his praises for a long time. I never felt he got enough credit in America. I hope in the United States they see this performance and they give him credit despite the loss, because I believe he's gained more notoriety in this fight. This is a worldwide stage here.
Well, I second that. He showed there what sort of courage and, you know, that mental grit and toughness and that warrior instinct to stay in there and carry on. And, you know, he didn't go down, he didn't get knocked out. He's leaving here with his chin held high. And, you know, he's intact. His reputation is intact, Kell Brook. He's a world-class welterweight. He might be a world-class light middleweight, but we found out tonight that he is not a middleweight.
Well said, guys. Kell Brook loses for the first time. What a battle while it lasted, and Gennady Golovkin celebrates and Kell Brook commiserates with the family. But right, it's been nothing to be worried about.
I'm curious about that right eye, though, that eye socket. You know, I wonder if there's a fracture there, because he was very uncomfortable about it.
Ladies and gentlemen, the challenger's corner, the red corner, indicated to referee Marlon Wright to call a halt to the contest. Challenger retires, the winner by TKO victory. His record now 36-0, 33 KOs, 23 consecutive wins by knockout. Still the undefeated, universally recognized middleweight champion of the world, Gennadyovich Golovkin, a.k.a. Triple King!
Fabulous to have him in London, Gennady Golovkin. What a stage, what a night. And Kell Brook covers himself in glory too, in a defeat that will still live long in the memory, maybe more than any of his victories. Possibly the Sean Porter win apart. What guts, what courage. But he fell short, as most predicted he would. And Andy Scott with, in the end, a very worthy winner.
Gennady.
Yes.
Just while they fix all number of belts to you.
Yes.
Congratulations. You promised a big drama show for the fans here. Five thoroughly exciting, brutal rounds. Talk us through it.
You know, first of all, thank you very much, London, like all public, like all fans, thank you very much. You know, I promise bring big drama show, because, you know, I know Kell, he's huge fighter, he's very good fighter, and sorry, he's not middleweight, it's not his way.
Did you feel then through the fight that you were too big, too strong?
You know, I know my style, just, you know, I respect him, he's good, and not so strong.
It was great to watch. Did he hurt you at all?
No, he just touched. You know, this is like training. I don't feel his power, and I stay like this and relax. Like, yeah, so many punches, and I don't feel.
A word on Kell Brook. A lot of people wouldn't fight you. Kell came up from his natural, well, they say it's his natural weight of welterweight to meet you at middleweight. A word on him.
Yes, I respect. Respect Kell, he's warrior, you know, and thanks to his corner, you know. First of all, for him, right, for his career, for his family, it's correct, you know, this, because I feel it's game over.
Okay,
finish.
Got all your team here, so let's talk about the future. Politics, money, egos aside, Who do you want to fight?
First of all, I'm a boxer. You know, just I'm open for everybody. For everybody, just I want unification fight.
Okay. In the build-up, I heard Abel Sanchez, your trainer, mentioned the names Eubank Jr. This fight didn't happen this time. James De Gea, would you come back to the UK to fight again?
Oh, absolutely. First of all, I would like Billy Joe Saunders because he has WBO belt.
The WBO champion, Billy Joe Saunders. You would come back to London to fight him here?
Of course, 100%.
Canelo has gone down to fight Liam Smith. If he came back up to middleweight, would you still want to fight Canelo with everything that's gone on?
I'm still in my way. Absolutely. I am open for everybody.
Let's have a word with your trainer, Abel Sanchez. Big smile on your face. Abel, is there a middleweight around at the moment that can stand up to Gennady's power, in your opinion?
No, I've said anybody from 54 to 68 wouldn't go 12 rounds with him. Kel is a very good fighter, as you saw right now. But eventually, they're going to break down. And eventually, his power and his ability to land clean punches is going to take effect, just like it did with Kel. I'm happy that the corner protected Kel because these guys are not going to quit. He's a warrior, and Dom felt it was necessary at that point, and I'm glad everybody's fine.
Okay, pleasure working with you guys this week. Congratulations. Let's have a word with a brave, courageous, ultimately defeated Kel Brook. Kel.
Yeah.
Must be difficult to put into words, but try for us.
I'm devastated. You know, he obviously can punch, but, you know, I expect him to be a bit bigger puncher. I think in the second round, I think he broke my eye socket, caught me with a shot. I think they were catching me with his biggest shots, and I was starting to settle into the fight, you know, but I was seeing three or four of them out there, so it was hard to get through it. But I think that I was tricking him. His shots were coming underneath, and I was frustrating him. I was standing there at times. I was starting to settle into it, but when you see three or four of them, you know, it's hard to carry on.
Did you feel that you did hurt him at all? He said there that he wasn't ever hurt, but you caught him with an uppercut in the first round and a couple of other times as the fight wore on.
Believe me, I hurt him. You know, when you're in a fight, you can see every movement of a fighter, and I've seen his legs buckle a couple of times. I was starting to settle in. I'm not taking nothing away from Golovkin. You know, he's a scary champion. Nobody wants to fight him. I would fight him again. You know, I mean, this with the eye, you know, stopped me coming forward. He's a great champion. I think that the fans, are, you know, I'm trying to get back to the fans, and amazing fight. I hope that they enjoyed the fight while it lasted. I wish I could go on, but when you see five of them, you don't know which one to hit. Hit the one in the middle, they said, but, you know, it started to get tough in there when you can't see, you know, against a great champion.
No, all credit to you. What about the weight issue? Do you believe that you are a middleweight, or do you believe that you're more of a super welterweight? Can you ever go back down to welterweight?
You know, we'll have to go back to the drawing boards, get on the machines, and see where I put a lot of muscle on. You know, I think I'd be more suited at 154, like middleweight. I think I'd be big, strong. I know that Canelo and Liam Smith are fighting next week. I'd love to fight the winner. You know, I think I've jumped up two weight divisions and boxed the man what everybody's running away of. And now we're ready to stand and fight with him. I'm starting to settle in, like I've just said. It weren't my night. I'm absolutely gutted because there were much, much more to come from me. I was just getting started, but I've seen five of them out there. I think I bust my eye socket.
Nobody knows better than your trainer, Dominic Ingle. And I presume you would have fought on regardless. Were you happy with the stoppage? Maybe phrase that wrong. You know, can you be angry at the stoppage?
I'm a warrior. I want to carry on, you know, but my team watching it from the outside, Dominic stood up. I was ready to fight on, you know. You have to kill me in here. Everybody knows that, who trains with me. I was starting to come on, you know. I was starting to settle in. You see me stand with him at times. I was starting to get into the fight. We knew that the first five or six rounds were going to be very tough, and then we were going to start boxing and taking over, standing with him a little bit, wearing him, stand, have a little war with him, and then go for a little walk and get the later rounds. But you have to talk to me, coach, about why you come up.
Dominic, your voice is gone. Okay, we'll bring in promoter Eddie Hearn. Eddie, Dominic's voice is gone. He's struggling to speak there. Just a word on the courageous ability of... Okay, let's try.
When you're in with Golovkin, taking too many shots.
Yeah. Eddie Hearn, a word on Kel. Tremendous effort. Where do you go now, and your thoughts on the fight?
Well, listen, you know, fans always want people to step up and fight the best, and Kel stepped up and fought the best. He was ahead on the scorecards, But at the end of the day, you know, his eye socket's gone and he's seeing two or three of them. He would fight all night, but the team, I know the fans want to see the fight go on as long as possible. But you know, you can't be fighting a guy like Golovkin when you can't even focus on the guy. So I think Kell deserves a huge amount of respect. I believe he's still one of the best fighters in the world. You know, no one else wants to fight Golovkin. He stepped up from welterweight to middleweight. You know, it wasn't just a middleweight fighting a middleweight. He wanted the big fights, no one wanted to fight him. And for five or six rounds, I think he's given Golovkin a hell of a fight there. And you know, like I said, Mauricio Sulaiman just told me he was ahead on the scorecards. I would have liked to have seen the fight go on, but you know, you can't let fighters fight with injuries like that. But I think Kell Brook deserves a lot of respect.
Just a word. He wants Billy Joe Saunders next. The names that were mentioned in the build-up, the likes of James DeGale and Chris Eubank Jr., who you obviously promote. What about those fights?
Yeah, listen, I think he showed that Golovkin is human. You know, it was a great five or six rounds that he gave him. He told he could hit him. He gave him great angles. But in the end, the power caught up. It damaged him. And Golovkin's a very, very strong man. And, you know, that fight was going to go into deep waters. I know you wanted to see it. But also, you've got a guy whose health's at stake as well. So, Kell Brook will be back. He's still the IBF welterweight champion of the world. We'll sit down, go away, and he'll be in some big fights in the future in this country.
Final word to you, Kell.
I'll be back. I'm sorry to disappoint, but I'll be back. You know, I get it, me all. When you can't continue, you can't. I'll be back. I love everyone here. If you've seen me win or lose, you've still come and supported boxing. Thank you all.
So, Kell Brook saying he was sorry.